acids in skincare. Thanks for joining me today. Extremely important video because when used correctly, acids are actually some of the most beneficial ingredients available in skincare, period. It's why you should watch this video. And I know many of you are skincare junkies. You're already on them. This will be a great review. I'm going to go through different acids. I'm going to, at the end, give you some pro tips, what never to mix. We're going to go through some concentrations and some ways that you can use them and why. All too common, you meet a friend. She has great skin and says, oh, it's glycolic. It's azelaic. It's salicylic, TCA, maybe a combination. The list goes on. Today we're reviewing them and we're clearing that confusion. Acids fight acne, wrinkles, age spots, scarring, and even uneven skin tone. Let's up your game and dive in. Click like and subscribe. Number one, salicylic acid. It's a BHA, beta hydroxy acid. Of course, it's been around a long time, but it's well known for its ability to exfoliate the skin and keep the pores clear, which helps reduce acne, acne-prone skin, and blemishes. It's oil-soluble as opposed to its relative glycolic acid, which is water-soluble. But the oil solubility allows it to go in and, as people like to say, hunt down the pores. Not exactly true, but it can get deep within the pore because a lot of times it's oil solubility that's needed. So where do you find it? Serums and cleansers, usually at concentrations 0.5 and 2%. So somewhere in there, it can be used in spot treatments for breakouts. Salicylic acid is also used in higher concentrations as a peeling agent for treating acne, acne scars, melasma, sun damage, and age spots in many dermatology clinics. You can certainly get it at those concentrations on your own as well. It's so effective, in fact, and you got to be careful because it is used in wart removal solutions and for thicker skin areas. It's safe to use in pigmentation prone and dark skin typically. Since it is related to aspirin, which is acetylsalicylic acid, it also has anti-inflammatory properties. Also lends itself for acne and acne prone skin. But you will find it in combination peels as well at those lower concentrations. You will find it in creams, and in my AHA BHA cream, you'll find it in there as the BHA component. And that's how I recommend most people to get their BHA. I do like salicylic washes as well. Number two, and next in line, glycolic acid. Glycolic acid is the most popular alpha hydroxy acid used in skincare today. Comes from sugar cane, and it's the smallest molecule alpha hydroxy acid. So it's the most effective in getting into the skin, and that's why it is, or one of the main reasons, certainly why it's the most popular, because it's absorption. It's water soluble, as I said. It's a fantastic anti-aging agent that seems to just do it all. This is one of them. So if you're dealing with both acne, skin aging, then glycolic is for you. This ingredient can kill two birds with one stone because it's very effective at exfoliating the skin, reducing fine lines, preventing acne, fading dark spots, increasing skin thickness, and evening out skin tone and texture. It's commonly found at concentrations below 10%. So in my cream, it's at 10%. So that's one way you're going to find it. Much like salicylic, glycolic acid is used in peels for treating those aforementioned issues. Now, I would normally in peels use it 10 to 30%, and we would back in the day try and get people up to 70%, which is pretty dramatic peeling. I don't recommend that at home. People would leave red, and it got scary at times, but it worked well. Combining and combinations are more common today and safer. So what you'll typically find is a lower percentage glycolic, like around 30%, with a bit of a beta hydroxy, like a salicylic, and people even throw TCAs and different products in there. But in a cream form, it's just perfect to add about a 10% AHA and then a 2% BHA, and it smooths the skin. The other thing that this will help with is keratosis pilaris, because it evens the skin. And for me, a lot of times what I notice when I'm on that type of a cream, one of the things that just makes you look a little more youthful is light reflection. It really smooths the skin. So for acne, acne scars, and keratosis pilaris, this works really well. So that combination you'll see commonly, and I love it. The number three on the list, mandelic acid. It's another alpha hydroxy acid, but one that's derived from bitter almonds. Now, like glycolic, it's an exfoliating agent, and it's useful for preventing acne, treating sun damage, and evening out pigmentation. However, due to its larger molecule structure, it doesn't penetrate the skin quite as deeply as your glycolic will, so it is less irritating. Because both glycolics and salicylics can be irritating, and for my cream, when you put it on, you'll notice you get a stinging for maybe a week, two or three, till your skin gets used to it, but this one is less irritating. It also slowly penetrates the skin, and thus that makes it less irritating as well. So if you're sensitive, you might consider that one. In a small study on 24 middle-aged adults applying mandelic acid, the product was used twice a day in that study, and the total time was 4 weeks. It improved skin firmness by 24%. And that paper was published in 2018 in the journal Facial Plastic Surgery. So for this reason, it's commonly recommended in peels instead of the glycolics, particularly for ethnic skin, which is more prone to that rebound hyperpigmentation or post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation. Rebound pigmentation occurs when resistance is built up to a particular substance due to excessive use. This causes the substance not only to be ineffective, but it also causes it to, of course, have the opposite effect on pigment than what you want. So be mindful, and that's why getting to know your skin is really, really important to being successful. And remember, stick to the creams with lower percentages if you're not going to educate or be one of these skincare junkies, which many of us are, because we go down that deep rabbit hole. Number four, azelaic acid, been found to be the mainstay of treatments for fighting moderate acne for the last 30 years. It's found in many prescription-only creams. It keeps the pores clear, it kills bacteria, reduces inflammation. Now, the percentage is typically 10 to 20% concentrations in creams that are designed to be applied all over the face and neck, and it can be used morning and night, so people like that. Azelaic acid generally has very few side effects, but in some people, if there's very sensitive skin, it can sting or peel, and redness can also occur. It also has skin lightening agents, and I know everyone's gonna pop on and say, oh, can I use it for skin lightening? And yes, you'll see it in those formulations, because skin lightening globally is so popular. A lot of people want lighter colored skin, and sometimes lighter colored skin, of course, can give a more youthful look because of the glow, but you will find it in those formulations for sure. A review published in August 2014 in the Journal of Clinical and Aesthetic Dermatology suggests it's also effective in treating melasma. And I know many of you are going to stop there, because melasma is a problem. It can be hormonal. It can be from UV light, heat. You got to know what's inducing your melasma. It's very difficult. Even when we use IPLs, lasers, it's very finicky. So melasma is a tough one, but this is an ingredient that's often found in those combination. It's also therefore frequently combined with retinoids as a milder alternative to hydroquinone. And of course, hydroquinone, depending on the concentration, is banned in many countries. I know many of you don't like using it. I personally don't have a problem with it, but a lot of times I'll use something like the Anti-Age Skin Brightener, which will lighten the skin color, doesn't have the hydroquinone, but you'll find it in those kind of products. Number five, you all know this one, kojic acid. It's produced by bacteria used in the fermentation of rice. Kojic acid inhibits the tyrosinase, which is responsible for producing the melanin, the pigment present in the skin. It's a popular ingredient in Asian skincare products thanks to its whitening and lightening anti-aging properties. Whitening is a term many Asian skincare brands use, and they refer to decreasing hyperpigmentation pigmentation or uneven skin tone. And I always want to be careful on this because a lot of people want to try and take their darker colored skin and turn it lighter. So we have to be careful brightening versus lightening. There are definitely combinations that can be used to lighten skin tone, but remember, melanin is a key target and the tyrosinase pathway is one way to get to it. This acid is found in cleansers and serums. The concentration you're usually looking for is 1-4%. Unfortunately, it's very irritating the skin, but it is also very effective. You'll see people try and punch through it, and I always get scared because if they're then getting sun or they're getting other treatments, their skin can be irritated, and chronic irritation leads to inflammation and aging. So please be careful with this one. Number six, we all know L-ascorbic acid, the vitamin C relative. The acid found in vitamin C works as a bleaching agent as well. That's why you'll find it in many combination peels. It can help restore imbalanced skin tone and help fade blemishes. This process is typically safe for a lot of skin types. It's suitable for most ages with no recovery time like traditional peels. It's well tolerated in that sense because remember, one of the reasons that people don't go up in their percentages of peels, obviously you can get inflammation, obviously you can get redness and irritation, but the pigment problems that can occur, and the vitamin C is sort of your anti-pigment type of peel. And that's why you find it, it's even in the VI peel, and have videos on the VI peel, which has TCA, ascorbic, salicylic, among other combinations of low levels. Ascorbic is the most common water-soluble form of vitamin C, and it's used in skincare, of course, for its anti-aging effects. It's also been used as a substitute for hydroquinone in treating melasma. That's why you see it in those brightening combinations, and it truly does work that way. Ascorbic acid is very unstable, as we all know, because we're all trying to find the holy grail of the form that's most stable, because a lot of times people get skincare that's not fresh and it's oxidized. So it's commonly available in more stable esterified forms, but of course its pure form is the most studied. Number seven, again found in combination peels, is TCA, trichloroacetic acid. And this one I want everyone to be careful with because I do see hyperpigmentation from this. People up the ante in the percentage, and it's typically a lower percentage, and people often want to get to 20, 30, 40%. Not the case with TCA. TCA peel chemically exfoliates the top layer of skin from the face, and it reveals a healthier, undamaged skin that lies beneath it. But definitely be careful. As I said, it addresses many skin concerns, including fine lines, sun damage, age spots, freckles, melasma, and hyperpigmentation, as well as acne scars. So people tend to get super aggressive with its concentration. If you have acne, TCA provides a deeper exfoliation to eliminate the dead skin cells and debris that lead to those breakouts. TCA can be used in percentages below 10% to as high as 50, but 50 is so high. Giving an example, in the VI peel, I believe it's around 12% in that combination, and that's a medical grade peel. Under the eyes, I know a lot of people use it for dark circles. Be very careful, you can get hyperpigmentation from using it if you're not careful. Although they're typically performed in a clinic, you can therefore perform the TCA peel at home at a much lower cost. The downside, of course, is without proper training, it does carry that risk of injury. So it's a classic one for people you trying to use at home and getting side effects. That's why I'm harping on that. As an alternative, other products and procedures are available that can safely and effectively exfoliate your skin, like AHAs and BHAs, so start very low in these concentrations. Now, which acid should I use? So choosing which one to use, it is the hardest part because there's so many, and my list there wasn't fully complete. The easiest way to go about it is by knowing what are you trying to treat. So let's break that down a little bit. Acne-prone skin, azelaic, salicylic, glycolic, lactic, and mandelic. Think mature skin, so you're thinking fine lines, wrinkles, signs of aging. Think glycolic, lactic, ascorbic, and ferulic. Hyperpigmentation, think kojic, azelaic, glycolic, lactic, linoleic, ascorbic, and again, ferulic. Okay, a couple pro tips. The higher the concentration, the more likely that you're gonna irritate the skin. And remember, the concentration of each acid is individual. So glycolics, you might take a 30 to 40%. You would never do that with a TCA. So remember, the percentage that you're using isn't across the board. You need to study each individual acid. How often should you use acids on the skin? For more mature skin, try a gentle chemical exfoliant twice a week. That's how I like people to start my AHA, BHA cream and then work it up. You should decrease frequency if the skin shows signs of irritation. What are you looking for? A windburn feel, redness, flaking. Any of those signs are inflammation, and we don't want that. You can work up to it, but not right off the bat. Always patch test, another good one. Where do we patch test? In front of the ear or behind the ear, even better. The dermis is pretty thick back there. Just try it, go slow, make sure the concentration's right for you. Don't mix face acids if you don't know them. So don't use a salicylic with any other acid at the same time if you're doing peels, because extreme skin irritation may occur. Avoid salicylic with products that contain niacinamide. Don't use a glycolic acid or lactic acid in combination with ascorbic acid. This will cause the ascorbic acid's benefit to disappear even before it begins to work. Avoid using AHAs with retinol. A caveat here is I tell people to alternate retinols one night or two nights and then use your AHA, BHA cream. But using them together can cause extreme irritation, and most people can't tolerate that. What are some things you do or you can mix? Azelaic can be used with retinoids. It can. AHA and BHA, great combination. Those are great mixes. Another thing you can do to get around problems is organize your acids between daytime and nighttime use. As an example, use salicylic in the morning and another acid in the evening. You'll still get the benefits of both if you can use separate applications. In that way, you don't even have to think about mixing them. Leave mixing them up to the people who are making the peels or making the combinations. I can tell you, in making just my AHA, BHA cream, we went through many combinations. I tested it. Then we used it on patients to see what they could tolerate. A lot of these patients were after getting procedures, before getting procedures. It's very complex, and the pHs make a big difference. If you're starting with acidic skin, then these products are going to be much more effective and potentially more complications. If you start with a base on the skin, or you don't clean it with things like alcohol or phenol, then you're going to have less of an effect, and many people want less of an effect. So all those things play a role. So if you're a skincare junkie, you can certainly study it. I hope that helps. Stay tuned here. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.